You're probably too young to remember, but at one point, almost all the Earth's landmass was clumped into one gigantic supercontinent called Pangea. Land was like you and your friends from high school, one tightly knit bunch. But then you graduate, people move away, you lose touch, and suddenly, it's 250 million years later, and the world's all spread out, and everyone but you is getting married. Okay, I got lost in the metaphors a little bit, I'm sorry. But the thing is, those forces that pulled the Earth's land in all directions are still here today. So what will the Earth look like in another 250 million years? That's a very long way off, so no one can say for sure, but we can make educated guesses based on what's happening right now. See, the Earth's surface isn't set in stone. The crust and upper part of the molten mantle, together called the lithosphere, are broken up into several tectonic plates that fit together like puzzle pieces. These plates glide around on the Earth's molten interior, creating mountains and volcanoes where they collide, new crust where they separate, and earthquakes where they slide past each other. The plates only move centimeters each year, but sometimes dramatic events happen suddenly, like the giant crack that just opened up in Africa. In March of 2018, a huge crack appeared in Kenya. There are a few possible explanations, like heavy rain or underground water washing away sediment, but it's also possible that Africa is splitting in two. The same forces that cause the plates to move can also break them apart, and right now it looks like the African plate is breaking up into unequal parts, the Somali and Nubian plates. Africa isn't the only continent making a break for it. Australia is on the move too. In fact, the entire country is moving north so quickly that it could throw GPS systems off in just a few years. If you take what we see happening now, you can run the clock forward a bit and extrapolate what is likely to happen. There's no guarantees though, since things move slowly and steadily, right up until the moment that they don't, and some unforeseen catastrophe changes everything. Anything past 50 million years in the future is really speculative, but it's fun. So let's speculate. Projections from Chris Gatiz, a professor from Northwestern University, have North and South America splitting up when Panama breaks away from Colombia. This is, of course, due to man's hubris when we dug the Panama Canal. I'm kidding, it's the same forces that slid Panama into the place it is today that will snap it off of South America again sometime in the future. So I guess Teddy Roosevelt could have just waited a while. Down Under will get a little less down and under as Australia makes a beeline for Asia. According to Scatese's estimates, it will smack into China, getting all up in its business and fusing together within 65 million years. Meanwhile, the northern edge of Africa will have joined up with the southern edge of Europe, completely eliminating the Mediterranean Sea. So don't buy beachfront property in Italy, it'll just be worthless. Around 100 million years from now, the Pacific Ocean will start getting bigger as the Americas drift toward Europe, but not before Alaska nicks a piece of Russia. And while all this is happening, Antarctica will start drifting into the Indian Ocean to see what the party's all about. It will join Brazil and Madagascar at the southern tip of Africa, while Newfoundland smushes into the Ivory Coast. In 250 million years, we could be looking at a new supercontinent, Pangea Proxima. Of course, this is one possibility. Another one is North America crosses the Arctic Ocean to snuggle up to Russia, forming another supercontinent dubbed Amasia. It'll amaze ya. You knew it was gonna happen. It's kind of poetic that the whole gang could get back together again. Of course, in all likelihood, it'll just break up again, and the cycle will continue until the Earth's molten interior cools or something else causes tectonic activity to stop. But that's way in the future. For now, just enjoy the ride. Especially you, Australia, you guys hang on tight. Tectonic plates move between 2 and 7 centimeters each year, which is about the same speed your fingernails and hair grow, respectively. Thanks for tuning in, and come back for more videos from Seeker.